living on an island, the way I love to get out on the river is to go in a rowboat and just row up into a creek, up into a bay. It's slow, so you're taking things in a lot easier. It's low to the water, so you feel very close to what you're seeing. I can take material if I want to and draw directly, or I can just go and look. It's the thing that connects me most to the river, is that action of moving my arms and my hands on those long bits of metal that are connected to a paddle that pushes the water. And it just feels like the most wonderful thing. It's what makes me feel connected to this place, is the rowing. Drawing is such a direct way to start off exploring and interpreting a visual idea. It's really about self-discovery. You go out into nature and it feeds you ideas. I'm looking at the play of light on water. I look at the oyster leases reflecting in the water. And it takes you somewhere that you would never have gone if you hadn't have been there just watching it. The more I looked, the more diversity I could see, and I tried to interpret that. And it was in the process of making just little simple notes in a little moleskin that I was able to just feel I was getting a vocabulary of the movement of wind, of the reflection of sky on water, the how they ruffled the texture of the water. And then the next step was to then look at how to take that further and to explore that in film. I really wanted to explore that fusion of digital media and of the handmade mark, as I really wanted the mark's influx to have a raw texture. I would go out and I would just experiment with everything. I'd pick up sponges, I'd pick up old, congealed, paint-hardened brushes, I would sticks, bits of thong, super balls, anything that had a different kind of firmness that could give a different mark. For me, it's always been a fascination with line, always been fascinated and intrigued by the movement in Chinese calligraphy and line. And I wanted to explore how the moving image could expand the dynamics of line, and then how the hand-drawn marks could expand the dynamics of digital media. And so Flux was trying to bring together those two ideas. Then when I started Flux, the actual visual ideas from that, well, they came from the wood, but they also came from listening to the music, to many different music, in particular the music of Arvo Part, listening to the spaces between the notes, listening to the tempo and the mood of the music. And that helped to generate visual ideas for starting the film. Once the film was started, it kind of generated its own ideas. When I first moved here, it was a very, very new environment to me. I'd never been exposed to the environments of oyster farms before, or mud flats before. And I lived here for at least, well over 15 to 18 years doing other activities. And I think it needed that time. It was like almost like a gestation to start to know where to take it, where I could go with it, how to interpret it, express what gave me so much excitement in looking at water, in looking at the bush. I mean, it's taken me 27 years to just start interpreting the textures of the bush, and that is one of my deepest loves.